First question. This was your 50th year coaching basketball, 27 years coaching Coe Brown. The last time you made it to the championship was 2003. Did you ever imagine that this was the year you would return to the championship?
No, because you never know. I've had the opportunity to be in, let's see, what it has been, about seven championship games, something of that nature, and over the years. And you never can take anything for granted.
Number 6. You know what I say to that ranking? Rankings don't matter.
That's not okay.
Have you seen the D-I?
We're gonna beat them.
Yeah.
Horsemen's ranked number one
already. We're going out there and Hollis playing them. They're ranked number 2 on the matchup there, but really no. It doesn't really matter. The matchups really don't matter. We're ranked number 6, but we feel in our mind we're better than that, so we're gonna go down there, have a good game, and hopefully come out with a win.
Turning point in the season? The first game when we got smacked.
The first one was after the very first game where we lost by like 20 points to Hollis Brookline. That was definitely a reality check for us.
Point, I guess a big eye opener would have been our first game against Hollis.
And we're like, this is not going to be easy. After that, we kind of realized we had to work and it wasn't going to just fall into our lap because we were that good.
Oh, you know, it's media day at Coe Brown. All the teams are shooting up.
Just another day.
Thank you.
gets a thumbs up today.
Happy birthday, Jerry!
Going into the game, we talked about a lot of defense, and we just executed in practice. We worked hard on rebounding and defense, and it all came together tonight. We also had a balanced attack. A lot of people scored. We were just moving the ball, penetrating, kicking, or just finishing. We made our free throws too, and the press also really bothered them, so it was a good win, fourth in a row.
This particular group all kind of felt very strongly for one another, and they defended one another, whether on offense or defense, and developed, you know, into a very close team as the season progressed.
If there was something you could do differently during the season, what would it be?
Probably nothing.
Who did you have the best chemistry with on the court?
Michael. Michael and I have always been the same play style, play type, and I think we work really well with each other. We have the same roles, so we connect really well.
When Scott and I played at the same time, I feel like we had a decent connection because I knew his game pretty well, and he knew what I could do, so I feel like when I played with Scott, we were pretty comfortable around each other.
Best chemistry was definitely with Sean. Very gritty players, knew what we had to do, we got our job done, played some solid defense, and kind of just put on the best players in the other team. We both knew where each other were from playing so long together, so that was pretty sweet.
Probably Sean or Mike. Probably Sean, because we played together so long and we've known each other for such a long time that it's kind of easy being out there. His game is good where mine is weak, and I'm better where he's weak, so we kind of complement each other.
Probably Sean or Dylan. Sean, just because I've been playing with him forever and I know where he knows where I am. And Dylan, because we were both like shooters, and we always had this thing where
if I had it on the wing, I'd always look for him in the corner. If he had it in the corner, he could swing it out quick to me, and it was just, I don't know, it was just the bond we had together, I guess.
I think the starting five had some pretty good chemistry as a unit. There wasn't really one person specifically, we all worked well pretty well. Turning point was definitely after we lost to John Stark at home. We were expected to win the game, but we lost. I actually got a technical foul, and I just felt like that sparked the team for the rest of the season, because we were on an 11-game winning streak or 12-game winning streak, and I think we were all confident, and we were like, okay, just another team we're going to beat. We lost, and I don't know, it just kind of woke us up a little bit, and since then, we just worked hard in practice, and we got the job done.
CBNA, and you already know what it is. Senior night, Bears about to eat some Bobcats. That's all you gotta know.
All right, man, you know, senior night tonight, big night, big crowd. You know, we've been here for three, some of us 4 years. It's been a long, emotional journey. And the reality setting in, it's our last regular season home game. Playoff run starts soon. Yeah, it's gonna be a sad night, but it's gonna be an exciting night.
What's up, man? How you doing?
Come here!
First of all, appreciate what we have tonight. You got a great crowd. Friday night. Last home game of the regular season. So, we need to keep everything in perspective there, starting with that. But, understanding the reason why we're here tonight, however, is to complete our mission of beating Oyster River. All right, coaches, anything else?
No, it's just rebound calls. The last time we played. Let's go.
Places packed. Let's go get them.
Come let's, on. Go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go, man.
What's that club?
Yeah, buddy!
Yeah, we're always like, I'm like, why is this place never packed? And then when it gets packed, everyone's like, it's too packed!
Here we go! Go to work! Right away! Right away! Let's go! Go! Get out! Here we go!
Here we go, Wayne Gunn, Happy Jim Nelson.
definitely the biggest competition of the year. They're definitely by far the best team we've faced. And this is one of the last games of the year, and it's going to solidify our seeding for the tournament. So it's very important, I would say. One of the biggest games I've played in my high school career.
three. I airballed the first one, but you know what they say? Last night took an L, but tonight I bounced back.
Let's go!
I thought
they came up to die.
Final game, playing Pelham, good team, we've got some good players. I think we're better, I think we're gonna get this W tonight. The fans are gonna be mobbing this place, they're gonna be loud, we're gonna get this win tonight.
Thinking back to all the highlights of the season, which one stands out the most to you and why?
Probably after we beat Milford in the final four, the semifinals, because like it was a good game. We were down 12-4 right in the first quarter, but we came back, ran the floor, got a lot of easy buckets, and we started rallying, and we ended up winning the game. And we all just realized how far our work had come, because we had one more game, which was the championship, and we were just like kind of in shock, because it was like we were playing in the last game of the season, which not obviously only two teams can do that, and we did it. So yeah.
Thank you.
If there was something you could do differently during the season, like regrets, what would it be?
I don't think I have any regrets. I think everything went well.
Probably nothing. I mean, just win the championship, I guess. But other than that, nothing. I think we worked and we gave everything we had, and we left it all on the floor.
Certainly, we knew early on there was something special about this team, but still, you never know what's going to happen. You know, during a season. But it was a special group, and it was certainly a fun year, and we were very fortunate to a lot of hard work by the players to get where we had to go.
Ever think you'll stop coaching?
Well, hopefully I'll be able to always coach a little bit in some form or another. I hope it will never be over as far as the coaching. But there will be a time when the varsity basketball will have to conclude. But hopefully that I will be able to have some impact of some type of team somewhere.
All right. Thank you.
You're very welcome.